and it looked for a second like it got picked.
Right.
Well, this is the football game right here, because now we're late in the third quarter, and I don't know where this is headed, but it's, what, 5 yards right. behind right. CeeDee Lamb? And I thought it was picked off for a second, but he did not quite get his hand underneath the football, right. okay? If that ball is picked off, you can see what's happening. Right. We're in huge trouble at this point.
And then on top of that, Skip,
there's you get a penalty.
You get
I don't know if we have the penalty.
Helmet, yeah.
But we get a helmet. It is actually a legal blindside right. block, yeah. but it could have just been a helmet to helmet right. call. But again, we get to, not only is it not an interception, but we get to tack on 15 yards. Well, this is the game right yeah. here, because if it goes the other way, I'm thinking, oh my God.
Yeah.
We could lose this game.
Right.
At this point, I tweeted, this is embarrassing. That's what I tweeted. That's why I'm going to give him a one on. I first guessed it, because here we go into the fourth quarter, and Indianapolis is outplaying us.
So, in other words, you gave them a one because you're like, hold on, this team, you're so much superior to this inferior team, and here we are late in the third quarter, and it's only a two-point game.
Yeah.
So you forget that they stepped on the gas in the fourth quarter, Skip, and took off on them.
Okay, but here's the point. I had just witnessed that throw to Alec Pierce. You realize Matt Ryan had led them on a 90-yard drive in 15 plays.
Yeah.
And in the first half, he had a 79-yard drive in 5 plays.
Right.
So was my defense exactly heating him up? Not yet.
Right.
Not yet.
They got him a couple of times, though.
Okay, but not like I expected.
Right.
And by the way, I'm going to go ahead and get this out of the way. I looked up the participation just to make sure. Micah had 50 snaps. Hand in the ground, so to speak. He doesn't put his hand in the ground, but as an edge rusher, 50 snaps, only one snap at linebacker, so they did it the right way.
Right.
And Micah was woefully quiet last night because he just didn't make much happen.
Just like I believe Tua, Jalen Hurts sees to the front of the league and MVP, Nick Bosa is in the front for the defensive player.
I can't argue against that because he was a monster.
Okay, you saw what I saw.
He was a flat-out monster because he destroyed Tua yesterday.
He had beaten that 14
and
a half.
Tua played even smaller than he was, but that had a whole lot to do with Joey Bosa. Nick Bosa, who's flexing and okay, I got it, but I kept waiting for 11 from Evan.
Yeah.
My old Micah, where are you, right. Micah Parsons? And they were scheming him, and they were screening him, and they were running through him and behind him, and they were doing all kinds of things. But he wasn't the one who caused fourth quarter havoc.
No.
So all of a sudden, off that one play, now we get to the offensive play of the game. And I will tell you this, a bright spot for me is CeeDee Lamb continues to emerge as a force, as a top 10 receiver. I can't do it off the numbers because he only caught 5 balls, but it seemed like he caught 10 balls last night because the two reverses he ran. Mm-hmm. But if I could show you the play, this is 3rd and 10 down at the 20-yard line. It is still 21-19. This is 14:29 left in the fourth quarter. So it's still a 2-point game, 3rd and 10, and this is underneath, and he cuts it outside, and look what Okay. This is the kind of play, but did he not make a move on the backer at that point?
Mm-hmm.
Cut outside, cut it up. He runs with the ball like I call it, a yak attack.
Right.
And that was the play of the game because that set up a little fade throw to Gallup for the touchdown that started to feel like it was breaking it open.
Right.
Okay. And now we go to what happened to Matt Ryan and company in the fourth quarter. If I could just show you the 4 in a row on one tape, I will. I'm going to show you the 4 straight turnovers that led to an avalanche of fourth quarter points. If we could see what happened from this point forward. Here's the first one. Matt Ryan throws.
Mo Alley-Cox. Yeah,
and he gets stripped.
Scoop and score.
Yep. And here we go. Scoop. And guess who? It's Johnny on the spot, Malik Hooker, who's trying to get revenge over the team that drafted him high and busted him. And here we go on the out route, and that's my man, Deron Bland. And here we go again, and Bland steps up again and takes it away from the receiver. And here's the strip sack, and the ball is loose, and it looked like Sam Williams had a touchdown, but they said he got touched. Okay, so there are 4 in a row, and they came like boom, 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 boom. 4 in a row, and to your point, you're shaving, and all of a sudden, It's 54-19.
Yeah.
So they got outscored 33-0 in the fourth quarter.
The second most points, Skip. That's the second most fourth quarter points since the merger.
Ever scored.
In
ever
the
scored.
Quarter. Yes.
It tied for the second most.
Yes.
It was also the most points scored in any quarter ever by a Dallas Cowboy team, 33 points.
Yeah. Well, most points scored this year by any team also.
That's historic. Okay.
That's twice you've done that, Skip. You've done some things that you've never done before.
Okay. And by the way, over the last 2 years, we have scored 50-plus three times, and that's the whole league has had three of those.
Right.
So we have the nuclear capability to explode on teams.
Yeah. But, Skip, like you were saying, if you just look at the numbers, and not you didn't watch the game, you just look at numbers, you're like, okay, they were 7-13 on third down, 54%. That's good. 1-1 on fourth down, 385. You're like, okay. 23 first downs for the Cowboys, 18. You're like, man, this was a close ball game. Time of possession is not that out of hand. How the hell did the team get 54 points with only 385 yards?
385 total yards, right?
In all my years of playing and watching, I've never seen something happen like this.
Okay. Matt Ryan had 12 first downs passing. Dak Prescott had 11 first downs passing. So if I told you that stat, and I ask you the final score, you wouldn't say 54-19, right?
No, no.
And then I look at, as you said, time of possession, but the Cowboys were 4-4 in the red zone, but Indy went 2-3 in the red zone, and you'd think, well, that's scary.
Right.
Like, that could
be. Skip, now I got the call-in question. You talked about how Matt Ryan had a higher QBR than Dak Prescott. How? He had three interceptions and a fumble. Dak had one interception. He threw three touchdown passes. How does Matt Ryan out QBR him? Under what in what light year? He's 21-6, 21-37. Dak was 20-30. So I'm trying to figure out how does the guy who throw for less touchdowns, throw more interceptions, has a fumble, get sacked more, and somehow his QBR is higher, Skip.
Okay, it is a subjective stat, but in the end, it's because for the first three quarters, he clearly outplayed Dak Prescott because they had those long drives, and he was really good. He made a bunch of really good throws.
Like you tell me, an NFL game is four quarters.
Okay.
So did they stop taking QBR after the third quarter?
Okay, I got you. But in the end, when I sat back and looked at my bright spots versus my ugly spots, I was not impressed. In fact, overall, it felt more like I was watching a pretender than a contender, even though my schedule is set up beautifully.
Yes.
I do believe my team was looking ahead. I think it's looking ahead dangerously to Christmas Eve.
Okay.
I think it looks at the schedule like, oh, we got the Dolts. They're not the Colts right now. They're the Dolts.
Yeah.
So we've got the Colts. Then we got Houston at home.
Go
to Jacksonville, who got shredded and waxed by
the Lions.
Detroit yesterday, who scored 44.
The Lions can score offensively.
I got it.
Had your boys in trouble.
Again, at Jacksonville can be dangerous. You know what they did to Baltimore 2 weeks ago. But again, you would set it up and say, well, you can win those next three to get to your revenge game against Philadelphia.
Right.
And if you happen to win that game also, you would be 12-3.
Right.
Well, that would work because then you have to go to Tennessee. That's no bargain.
Right.
And you have to go to Washington to close it out, and that's no bargain.
Yeah.
But maybe that won't even matter.
That's a rivalry game, and they did a great comeback and tied the Giants. I think, you know, your two games are going to be back-to-back. Like you mentioned, the Christmas Eve game against the Eagles and then Tennessee. But I mean, looking at the way the Eagles played yesterday, Skip, good luck.
They feel like they are uncatchable. And I look at their closing schedule, it ranks the 18th toughest. Dallas is the 17th toughest. But when I look at the Eagles, they go to the Giants, they go to Chicago, that's win-win. Then I think they're going to lose to the Cowboys. I'm already on record with that. But then they finish at home with Saints and Giants. Okay, what if they win four of their last five?
Well, you can't catch them. Even if you win out, you can't catch them.
No. You can't catch them. So in the end, all I know about last night is it's over. All I know about last night is it went in the win column. All I know about last night is it does not bode that well going forward because I don't know who my cornerback. I don't know if Deron Bland can he's a slot corner.
Right.
He ran 4.45 in his pro day. out of Fresno State, played at Sac State for quite a while, and then finished last year at Fresno State. Can he move outside and play the outside?
You better hope so. Well, but Skip, you should be proud. The Cowboys are one win away from having double-digit back-to-back winning seasons since the first time since 96. If the playoffs started today, you know who y'all got, right? Fourth seed would be the Bucks.
Okay.
Y'all would go to Tampa.
Okay.
You would like that matchup. You would love that matchup.
Well,
you would pick the Cowboys. I guarantee you pick the against the Bucks, the way the Bucks are playing and the way your Cowboys are playing.
I would have to see how the Bucks are playing at that point, because they have a hellacious finishing schedule to me, because they got their nemesis Saints tonight. Then they have to go to San Francisco. Then they go home and play Cincinnati.
But here's the thing, though, Skip. San Francisco, we're going to talk about this a little later. San Francisco without Jimmy G. Can Mr. Irrelevant, Brock Purdy, who was the last pick in the draft this year.
By the way, I like Brock Purdy. I watched him for 4 years at Iowa State. He's pretty good, but he ain't no Jimmy G at this point.
You're asking a rookie quarterback with very little experience to take you all the way.
I agree.
But their defense is legit.
It looks like it's the best in football.
Their defense is legit.
Yep. So, all I know for sure is my Cowboys are 9-3, and I'll take it and run with it.
I mean, you talk a lot of this. I'd rather be let on Hurts. Everybody hurts.
Yeah, everybody hurts. I tried to warn you.
The Cowboys going
to
hurt.
I tried to tell you. Yep.
11-1. Didn't know they were 11-1.
Maybe we're going to have to beat Philly twice.
You ain't beat nothing.
You might have to.
As a matter of fact, they're going to sweep you.
We might have to go back to Philly for the NFC Championship.
You're not going back. You're not going back.
We might.
Philly going to come in.
Nope. You want some cases right now? I'll take it right now.
You talking real big?
I'm on record. I've got Dallas over Philadelphia. Revenge will be served on Christmas Eve. It's going to be a very merry Christmas Eve.
Your team just scored 54 points, and you gave them a one on the impressive meter.
I'm just being honest with you. I didn't like it.
You just gave them a one.
You know what? But it's a dub. They did not come to your restaurant last night.
AJ Brown. Yeah. Oh, can you?